You're about to leave when you suddenly hear a loud roar. The face of a fire giant appears from a corridor. He snarls at you with fiery lips. Ah, some more food at last. I've had nothing sensible to eat for years. With these words, the Colossus moves out of the corridor and attacks you with his huge club. And there he is. Should we wait for him to come? I think he might have a spell, like a fire blast, so maybe we should move up to immediately engage him. And I think Wind Devil is single monster, okay, so Wind Devil for you. Maybe that'll put out your fire a little bit. ...13 damage. Oh, he's casting the fire beam spell. Ow. Okay, so far. I'm gonna keep on with the Wind Devil and hitting him. He's rocking him. Rocking his world. 9 points of damage. 22. Okay, we're gonna need to start healing here. Healing potion 2. Not sure if that's quite enough at this point. Well, that's what we have a lot of. This is Selena. She'll heal with potions. She's quick about it. Let's hope this 2 gives her enough. Down to half her hit points. Wind Devil again. Oh, that's better. 8 points. Okay, good. He stopped using that. At least for the moment. I am very glad we have a magic user. We deflected it this time. In the party. Really adds a bit of oomph to these combats, that's for sure. 8 points. He's doing the most damage consistently. Fourteen, nice. Last Wind Devil. Spell failed, nice. Spell points 4, 5, no, 3. Seem to be doing alright. Just... Okay, so the lowest one we have is spell points 3. Poof. Good. 150 experience. Nice. Agile level 10. 129 life points. 12 training points. He's got 2 attacks per round now. That is awesome. 289 gold, no rations. Regular leather and club. Okay, we've defeated Mr. Fire Giant. There's a little doorway and there's something back there. Yes, and then. Let's see what's back here, if anything. Pile of skulls. Checking the pile of skulls, not finding anything. Oh! In this basket, you find some of the property of the victims of the fire giant. It explains all the dead people. 264 gold, which you will promptly take. Hats, a steel helm, a robe, clothes, chainmail shirt, short swords, a scimitar, dagger, knives. Leather shoes, leather boots, a buckler, and a small shield. Well, let's take as much as we can of things that we think would give us some money. Do we need a hat? Anyone need a hat? We're actually good with hats. Hats are really cheap. Boots I'll take, and a small shield. Alright. I'll take the buckler too. Why not? We might end up dropping some of this stuff at some point. Short swords? Why not? Maybe we can sell it in Burnville. Might as well take all we can, and if we need to drop stuff, we will. And that's it. I say let's rest again. Oh no, not dropping. Moving. She's probably just gonna need one. So it means we just gotta wait around. How many hours has it been? He's close enough, actually. Okay. continuing on. I wonder how much more we have to go. Actually, this might be the exit. It's right in line with the entrance there. Funny how when you look through the door, you just see more... What do you call it? Dungeon. Alright, so it's quite an expanse of desert to the south. To the east is Burnville, but across some water. This might be it. Well, most of us are gonna get hurt going across that. Ah, a bridge. That's not on the map I have. Yay! Next town. So exciting. You'll be able to return to this point later. As you enter the town, you immediately see there must have been huge fires. Almost all the houses are badly damaged, and everything is black with soot. There seems to be no one around, and it is deathly still. Does that mean we can't get our training done here? I thought I saw a person through that doorway. Are there gonna be monsters here? Okay, what's this here? The sign shows an anvil, a hammer, and a pair of pliers. Below them is written, Smithy and Workshop. We repair everything. At least we try. Open from 6 a.m. to 8 p.m. Okay, so they're open if anyone's alive inside. I'll be able to return later. Good. What does it say on the map? Blacksmith. You search through all the rooms, calling, but the house is apparently desolate and empty. Oh, we can't even go in and look around. Okay. The sign says bathhouse, sauna, water treatments, whole body massage. Oh, what a shame. Could use a massage after all that. Is this... That's the same place you just been. Okay. I mean, it doesn't have a desolate sound about it with the music. Alright, same thing. Desolate and empty. Bathhouse. Huh. Very interesting. What does this one say? Oh, same thing. Nothing here at the end. All this. Okay, this is the center of town here, I guess. Golden letters on the marble slab read, House of the Healers of Burnville. Below that is a handwritten note, Dr. Jonathan not available due to illness. Mixed goods. We mix, you buy. Open from 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. Huh. So healers and mixed goods. Okay, we can go in here. House of the Healers. Is this water? We're not walking on it in any case. Get these trees out of my way. Hello, anyone here? All these pillows. Behind some books about herbs, Citrine finds a few loose pages from a diary. Attached to one of them, with wax and thread, is a small key. Bulgar key. Oh! Gotta be referring to this. Bulgar Burj, which I'm thinking means Bulgar Mountains or Bulgar Range. Something like that. Alright, so we'll take the Bulgar key. Sabine's diary. Yeah, we're looking for her. Nothing else in here. Bunch of pillows. What if we poke the pillows? Is she hiding under them? Now, just to remind you guys, because it's been a while since we talked to anybody about this. Oh, I think I'm in the wrong... I'm in the wrong little notepad. Where's my notepad? Oh. Oh, Burnville. Captain Torl. We have to tell Captain Torl the apprentice says to return to Spannenberg. And then Sabine is at Burnville. Island to south in middle of desert. Well, that's where we are, I think, now. Daughter to Sandra. Get word to Sandra. That's what my notes say. Key opens shortcut to Burnville. Go from Quay southwards to next island to get to tunnel. Yeah, we've done that. Alright, so we have to get word to her mother. Who's her mother again? Sandra. Alright, so we're looking for Sabine. On behalf of her mother, Sandra. Okay, I have to use it to look at it. Or read it. Someone wrote the following in beautiful handwriting on a few pages of parchment. Today, one of my greatest fears came true. Some ancient, dark force rose from the old tower of the Black Magicians to overpower us. This morning, a huge red dragon appeared in the sky. It dived down over Burnville, and with its fiery breath, set all the roofs alight. As the inhabitants came running out of their houses, it roared, saying something like, "Listen, you poor little worms. My master, the Master of Fire, has seen fit to make you his slaves. He gives you until tomorrow to consider. I shall return then and expect your answer." Then it flapped its mighty wings and rose high up in the sky again. The gales it caused blew the roofs off several other houses. We held a meeting this evening, and it was decided we will not surrender, but will fight. Our plan of resistance was a mistake. The dragon returned early this morning, as announced. When we refused to surrender, it roared loudly, and suddenly the sky darkened with the wings of thousands of other dragons. Oh my god, thousands? Sorry guys, I don't know why that does that sometimes. Thousands of other dragons, in less than half an hour, all the inhabitants except me had been caught in nets. Many were badly burned and had other injuries as well. The dragons flew off with them, probably to the tower. I still do not understand how it was not discovered in my hiding place, but now I have no idea what to do. I spent last night thinking about what I can do now. By the morning, I decided to go to Spannenberg and ask my mother for help. What a problem! I did not even manage to get through the tunnel. Shortly after I entered it, a huge giant stepped forward. He laughed repulsively and said, "Luminor, the Master of Fire, has instructed me to let no one through." But he did not say that... He did not say that I must let you go again. So now you can serve as my dinner. He raised his arms up high and enormous balls of fire hurtled towards me. I only just escaped the inferno. I recovered as well as I could in just one night. I will go to the tower now. Perhaps there is chance of freeing the people of Burnville from the clutches of Luminor. May Gala be with me. Sabine. Chief Healer of Burnville. Wow. Alright, so she is not here. She's at Luminor's Tower, which is... here. Which I'm not sure how to get to. We'll figure it out. Maybe if I find, what's his name? The Harbor Master? Is that what it says? We can take a boat over. Because the boat will be able to go through the deeper waters, but the raft cannot. Learn that in Amberstar. Captain Torl, we're looking for. Anything else around? These people like pillows. We gotta check all these, that's for sure. Nothing. Alright. What about this? And what about this? Nothing within. Did I look at this one? I gotta... Well... Getting dark out. Golden letters on the marble slab read, House of the Healers of Burnville. Oh yeah, I read that. Maybe I'll return later. Was I in? This is all connected. Wait. We came from this way. Wait a second. Or, okay, I didn't realize I could go this way. It's all the same building. The door before you has a small brass sign, Library of the Healers, Magic Scrolls for Healing. As no one comes to serve you, even after a few minutes, you leave the shop again. Well, the place is deserted. There's not going to be anyone to serve us. Next to the door ahead of you hangs a small brass sign, All Kinds of Healing. Same, we leave the shop. Can't check the map in these kind of areas. That goes out. I just want to make sure I've seen everything. And this is where we've been. So there's two doors, the way we came out, and there's that one. Luckily, even at midnight, we can explore this place. Which makes sense in towns, they'd have lights out and stuff. Doesn't make sense in this town that we'd be able to see. See what's down here, if anything. I'm not sure what this is. Okay, desolate and empty. Let's see. Maybe we can rescue these people. Artist's house, and then... Oh, that's the chapel part of the healer, okay. And then that we can fill this town up again. That'd be cool. That's the bathhouse again? Oh, I went back. I meant to go that way. Let's go this way now. Funny how you walk through a town and you're attacked by bandits, and then you walk through a deserted town and there's nothing here to fight you. Not criticizing, just saying that might have been a purposeful choice. Mixed goods. Oh yeah. So wait, ahead of me. Hercules Sulp Food, open from 8 a.m. to 6 p.m. We're gonna leave the place because there's nobody there. Empty here. And then this is the mixed goods, I think. Merchant. Mixed goods merchant. What's up here? Wait a second. We have this wall. It's a wall, but I have to map it out. South. Just in case we do get attacked by some dragon or something. Door here, there's a sign here. The golden sign says House of Art and Poetry, M. Helmick, cartographer, D. Rodermund, artist, T. Goldstein, jeweler, and M. Weissnick, mystic. Weissnick the mystic. Let me guess. Deserted. Desolate and empty. What is this place called? Artist's House. Oh, okay, there's just multiple entrances to the artist's house. Okay. So, if we fill this place up with people again, we rescue these people, we'll know where everything is. Well, because it'll be marked on the map. Does the sign say something different? No. Good thing the signs didn't burn away. Same. Desolate. Let me guess, artist house still? Cool. Yeah, it seems to be a major landmark of the town. If it wasn't for the cheerful music, this place would be rather creepy. Especially in the dark like this. I don't want to do that. Alright, so let's... Which way am I heading? I'm heading back up. So let's Go here. And turn this way. There's like an alley or something going this way. Artist house, let me guess. And deserted. We've gone all around the place. Oh, I'm back over here. Meant to go this way. I think I've seen this. Well, there's nothing in there. A strange blue glow is emitted through a crack in the wall to the south. Really? Supposed to be doing with this blue glow. As Citrine moves her hand closer to the blue light, it spreads silently over the entire wall and glows brightly. After a while, the blinding brightness fades slightly and the wall disappears.